So I was very keen to do electronics, but I knew that I had to really, really work hard to get into University of Moratuwa, and only 25 students were taken at the time. But I was fortunate enough to be selected to Moratuwa, and I was being able to do electronics engineering, and I think that changed my life. After I graduated, I joined the newly established Computer Science and Engineering Department as an instructor. I had the privilege of teaching the first batch of computer science and engineering students of University of Moratuwa. I realized that the private sector IT companies were struggling to find good quality professionals. At the time, we were not producing large number of IT professionals. I did a simple calculation, and all universities, computer science as well as students who did computer science as a subject, would have been about 200. So I actually wrote a proposal to start an institute within the University of Moratuwa to churn out IT professionals in large numbers. Although people kind of agreed to this proposal, but nobody funded this proposal. So that idea was not very successful, but then we group of professionals got together and decided to form Sri Lanka Institute of Information Technology. We started our institution on the 16th floor of BOC Merchant Tower, and we decided to enroll students. In fact, we did not have any degree awarding status at the time. This was in 1999. So we invited applications for the diploma program. We received over 3,000 applications, and we enrolled 400 students, in fact 395 students. And then again in the following year, it was so popular, we received over 6,300 applications and enrolled 600 students. So now we were producing training large numbers of IT professionals. Then during this time, Mahapala Trust Fund agreed to provide funds and this land, and then in 2002 we completed the facilities here, the first buildings here. With that, we were able to enroll more than 1,000 students. So while I was working as a director of computing services center at the University of Moratuwa, I had the opportunity to interact with organizations like Expo Development Board and Board of Investment. Particularly with Expo Development Board, we realized that as a Expo promotion agency, we were not really using technology to promote our products and services. So I looked at how we can use technology to improve the situation, and decided to establish what is known as TradeNet SL. Also, we allowed these local companies to transact through this platform. So we launched what is known as Cyber Trader, and that was the first electronic commerce platform of Sri Lanka. The ICT strategy that we developed under the competitiveness initiative supported by USAID at the time. After this strategy was developed, Minister Milinda Morogoda, he asked me to come and hand over the strategy. So we gave the document, and he worked with World Bank, people like Dr. Nagi Hanna, who used to work with us a lot, burning midnight oil, basically how to structure this East Sri Lanka initiative. And I'm very happy to say that saw the birth of ICT Agency of Sri Lanka, which has done tremendous work to develop the industry. We also wanted to have an industry association coming out as part of this strategy. We developed one that was not very successful, but later, a couple of years later, we all got together and developed SLASCOM. So the birthplace of SLASCOM, I should say, was at the ICT agency.